Did you know that ancient Egyptians made some of the most wicked stone arrowheads in all of history? And that's because they had these long thin barbs that when shot into you could easily break off and cause all kinds of problems. This style of arrowhead is called a hollow base point. It's pretty rare to find these arrowheads still intact because they're so fragile. There's only a few known examples, and that's because it has the deepest concave base of any projectile point known in history. Now these are so difficult to make. I've been trying and trying, and every time I break off these barbs here. But in this video, we're gonna actually make one. And I'm gonna base it off a cast of an original Egypt arrowhead. You can purchase these exact reproductions at the Lithic Casting Lab website. And there you can get more information about these amazing Egyptian points. I'll put a link down below. So let's go see if we can flintknap an ancient Egyptian hollow base arrowhead. So here's a stone that'll shape to make an Egyptian arrowhead. You could use flint or chert, or in this case, obsidian. Obsidian is natural volcanic glass. I found this in Oregon, and it's perfect for making stone tools. I'll begin by striking off flakes with a hammer stone. This is a river rock that fits nicely in the hand, and I turn it into a tool. I'll begin by looking for a ridge. Here's a ridge, and I'll strike it. You'll start taking off flakes. I'm looking to make what's called a biface. It's a flat piece that's pretty thin. But this is pretty thick, we have to reduce it quite a bit. I'll also use antler to hit it. As it starts to get thinner, I'll grind the edges to make platforms. And then you can take off the high spots. Well, I worked our biface down so it's nice and thin. It's still too big for an arrowhead, but first I want to put in the notch. I've had so many problems with breaking off the barbs, so I'm going to attempt to put in the notch and then shape it afterwards. So let's see if we can do this. I broke the last 12 I've tried. I'm going to start by pressure flaking that notch in and see if we can get it to match the original. I have a leather pad with a notch there to help support it. And just take off little flakes. This is such a delicate process because you have to put quite a bit of force to take off those flakes, and I really don't want to crack these barbs here. We'll keep trying. So far, so good. We're getting closer. Just a little bit more. No, that's what always happens. I busted it off. But if you look, I can still try to make another one and salvage it. We'll see what we can do. Well, I did get the notch deep enough to make an arrowhead, but there's quite a bit of extra on the outside. So I'll have to be very careful and flintknap it into shape So it looks just like this one. Well, it is so satisfying to finally be able to make one of these arrowheads. They are so fragile and they break easily. After many failed attempts, I was about to give up, but I kept with it and we have one. Now I want to show you what these look like when they're mounted to an arrow. We'll start with an arrow shaft that has a notch in the tip to fit our point. It slides in here like this. And you can see the barbs and how easily they break off once it was shot into you. You wouldn't be able to pull it out. Now we can glue in our point with some natural glue. This is known as asphaltum. It's naturally occurring asphalt that when you crush up in heat, you can make into a glue. When it cools, it becomes very hard, but it's sticky when it's hot, so we'll heat it up, then secure our point. We'll stick that right in the notch. I'll heat up that little dab and then stick in our point. There, that fits nicely, and when it cools, it'll be very secure. So in ancient Egypt, here's what a stone arrowhead looked like. I would never want to be shot with an arrow, but especially not with this one. With those long barbs, you can never pull it back out, and they'd easily break off, cause all kinds of problems. Thank you so much for watching. I love doing projects on ancient history, and I want to do more. If you like these kinds of videos, leave a comment down below, and make sure you stay tuned for more great videos. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have a mouse problem, please consider clicking the link in the description and purchasing one of the mouse traps I invented. It's called the Dizzy Dunker Mousetrap, and I consider it to be the greatest mousetrap ever made.